I was at a mass recently at a parish that isn't my own, in which the priest seemed to take a lot of opportunities to ad-lib with his own thoughts and colloquialisms in place of what is written in the Roman Missal. Now, this isn't something that I'm used to, so my initial reaction to it was anger and frustration, because the texts that compose the Mass are a treasure of the whole church, and they don't belong to any individual person or generation. For any one person to think that they ought to make cute improvements to something that has traces as old as the faith itself would seem to suggest that they are more concerned with the attention that they are getting and the way that they can insert themselves into something rather than how they should be serving and how they are called to serve in the liturgy. The analogy that came to mind for me was like someone who is appointed as a new curator of this great museum that houses ancient and priceless treasures. And they think that the whole collection could be improved if it had a bit of their own personal touch. So they start running around, adding dabs of paint here and there, and then rearranging exhibits and collections according to their own personal preferences. Now that probably sounds a bit hyperbolic, and I could probably admit that it is, but at the same time, considering how sacred and ancient the liturgy is, you could probably argue that tampering with it to suit your own personal preferences is actually, it's quite a bit worse. But as I reflected on it and thought about it, and perhaps because of the grace that I received on the occasion through that sacrament, I was reminded of something that helped me sympathize a little bit with what was going on. Before I go on, I want to say a quick thank you to Clean Browsing for sponsoring this video. Clean Browsing is an internet filtering system designed to protect you and your family against things on the internet that you'd rather not see, which I think we can all admit, there's plenty of that out there. Now, there's lots of options out there for safe browsing on the internet, and my family and I have tried plenty of them, but this is the one that we actually use for a number of reasons. But probably the best reason is because it's reliable and it's not intrusive. The biggest difference with it is that it's not software that you install on each device. Instead, it's a routing technique that you can use for any particular device or for an entire network, so that your home, your school, or your office are all covered by the same system without having to install it on every single device. Other systems I've used in the past were at times really glitchy, easy to get around, or they would just slow everything down because they're so intrusive and I guess they're just wasting memory or something. Clean Browsing saves you from all of that because it keeps your devices free from any intrusive software so that they're running smooth and fast and safe and reliable. So if that's interesting to you, check them out. Their website is cleanbrowsing.org, and I will include a link anywhere I can, wherever this video is posted. Before I became Catholic, I spent quite a bit of time in other denominations and churches trying to figure out what made sense, what did I believe, and where did I fit in. And honestly, evangelical churches were a highlight for me. And one of the things that I really appreciated about them was this sense of authenticity that emerged in their prayer services. For example, there would be moments where individuals or people like the pastor would get up on the platform or the stage or whatever you call it, and they would lead in a kind of prayer that seemed authentically from the heart. Ironically, this was all a production that was actually very well rehearsed, but it was designed to appear to be spontaneous and full of candor. When I first started attending Mass, I was somewhat discouraged by what appeared to be a complete lack of personal expression in the prayers, whether that be the person leading or those responding and reciting. So for example, when the priest would lead in prayer, it was always something that was read from the Missal, I just saw a book up there, in a very monotone and robotic way. And then whenever people would respond, it was the same kind of thing. It was often from memory, or they were reading from cue cards or from missalettes, and it seemed to be empty of passion, of feeling, or personal investment. And I couldn't help but think that this is just not the way it's supposed to be. And it's no wonder that the stereotype of your typical Protestant is someone who has a personal relationship with Jesus, and Catholics, on the other hand, always appear to be people relying on a scripted and institutionalized religious framework to tell them what to do and to say. So I can understand and even sympathize with some priests who are struck by this same problem, who feel the need to add some personal touch to what they're doing up there so that it at least feels like there's some humanity to it. Surely a faith as romantic as Roman Catholicism shouldn't be characterized by a robotic, monotone recitation of what it means to be a follower of Jesus. This apprehension to simply just recite prayers in a scripted way used to bother me so much that I remember when I used to pray the rosary, I would do the same kind of thing. I would adapt the prayers of the Our Father and the Hail Mary and fill them with synonyms and variations so that it was an authentic expression of my own faith and what I believe. But at a certain point, I stopped doing that. And then enough time passed where I had almost forgotten that this used to bother me about our liturgy until I saw this priest doing the same thing that I used to do in my own personal devotional life. And then I realized why I had forgotten it. And I realized that this suspicion, this apprehension that used to bother me, this sense that we're not supposed to be droning through the liturgy in monotone voices, I think that's right. What we're supposed to be doing is singing it. And the reason that this hasn't bothered me for a while, and I think the reason that I have forgotten about it, is because for about a year now, my family and I have been predominantly attending the extraordinary form of the Mass, in which there's hardly ever a moment in which the nave and the sanctuary aren't filled with the sounds of singing voices. And this really drove home the fact for me that over the past century, we've really wrecked our liturgy. And don't get me wrong on this, I'm not the kind of person who refuses to acknowledge or accept the new or ordinary form of the Mass. I'm certainly not one of these Latin at all times and only ever kind of guys, because that's actually a really hard case to make. But I am someone who will say that we've completely messed up in how we've implemented the reforms that were supposed to take place. And even a quick perusal of the Second Vatican Council's document on the liturgy, Sacrosanctum Concilium, will really reveal that fact. The Catholic tradition of using music in prayer is designed to try to elevate our senses to something transcendent, to beauty itself, who is God. But over the past century, Western culture has embraced this notion that music is solely about being entertained, that it's for our amusement. And the irony of this modernist revision is in such a high dosage. So music in classical Greek thought was any art that was inspired by a muse, or that in which the muses presided in. Amusement means that which is without a muse. That's literally what the word means. Just like atheism, a-theism, a-without, theism, God, means without God. Amusement means without a muse. In other words, amusement is the antithesis of music. And that's pretty much all we have with modern conventions of music. We judge it based on a criterion of how much it amuses us. And I'm afraid that that sentiment has really infected the life of the church. But the traditional Catholic understanding is a lot more like the classical Greek one, except that God was our muse and our prayers were the lyrical expression of our love for him. That's what the Mass is supposed to be. It's supposed to be musical. And just like hearing someone read out the lyrics from a song with no cadence or expression or timing, hearing Catholics recite the Mass without singing it just feels wrong. If I could try to diagnose what I see happening in most Masses that I've attended outside of the extraordinary form, it seems like we've allowed this modern Western notion that music is for our amusement, and since that's what it is, we will use it as like entertaining interludes between the boring parts of Mass. And I think this is part of the reason why we fight so much about liturgy now, because we can't all agree on what is entertaining and what amuses each of us. Well, what if we just dropped the desire to be amused or entertained and sung the Mass through chant itself, and then discover what it's like to focus our attention back on God where it belongs, instead of our own personal desire to be amused and our own personal egotistical preferences. God is supposed to be our muse, and parts of the Mass are supposed to be like our love song to him. So I think it would make a lot of sense if we stopped monotonously, robotically rehearsing and reciting the prayers of the Mass and got back to this idea of singing it, singing those prayers and singing the Mass itself as it was intended to be. Thank you so much for watching that, you guys. If you enjoyed this video, then please consider subscribing and hitting that bell if you're on YouTube, or just liking and following from wherever you are and wherever you happen to be watching this from. And if you want to support the making of these videos, then please consider supporting my work as a digital media and marketing expert. My company, Holdsworth Design, is a branding and communications company that specializes in web design and logo and branding, graphic design, videography, and communications and marketing strategy. So if you know of a parish or a diocese or a business or a ministry that needs help in those areas, then please send them our way, and I'm sure that we can probably help them out. And be sure to check out the website, which is holdsworthdesign.com.